Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Data Analytics program using MS Excel. And today is our day 8 of our training. And this is our session number 1. So guys, so far, if I talk about what all we have done, we have discussed a lot of concepts on Data Analytics training program. So right from the concept, like how we can open MS Excel. Okay, how can we open MS Excel right from that moment? Till yesterday, we did advanced filter, some ifs, count ifs, we did subtotal, data connection, data consolidation. So we have discussed a lot of concepts. So probably if I start writing and all, it would take a lot of time for us to remember what all we have discussed. The only thing I just want to know from your end, that are you people understanding or not? That is very important thing. So we have discussed so far a lot of concepts on MS Excel. Only thing is that how much you can retain, that is very important thing. So guys, yesterday I have sent you an Excel file in Google link where there's a different sheets are there we're going to discuss the concept of VLOOKUP. So I really request all of you to please open that Excel file, everyone. So if you can open the workbook what I have sent you, that is of name called VLOOKUP dummy data. So if you see VLOOKUP dummy data, so first I'll talk about basic VLOOKUPs. So in today class we only focus only on VLOOKUP. We'll concentrate on VLOOKUP in today class. So everyone, please open that VLOOKUP dummy data. So if you open that VLOOKUP dummy data, come to this sheet worksheet called VLOOKUP data. So here you can see in this sheet, you will see a data where you can see different products, okay, under different customer. You can see that. So you have a product like Alice Mutton. Okay, there are different data, different set of values are there for Alice Mutton for different customer. Then you have another product called Any Seed Syrup. Then you have another product called Boston Crab Meat, Camber Bird Parrot, okay, Chef Anton, Cazon Seasoning, Philo Mix, Goguza, Telino. So there are different products are there, guys. Veggie Spread. If I talk about what all total products are there, then probably what I need to do, I can use count, I can use sum if date. I can use subtotal on this to get to know more about the some individual sums of product wise or customer wise. If I want, I can do that. Here data is already in ascending order. So I just need to press on DB. So yesterday we discussed subtotal, right? So subtotal at each change in product wise, you want Q1, Q2, Q3, sum, you press OK. And then here you can see all the product name. From this I can get the product. If I want the list of products, I can get the product from here. I'll copy this, Control N, then Alt ESW. And Control V. Okay, so again the data coming like this. So what is the point then? I wanted only these values. So what I can do just for this. So I'll select this Control Shift down arrow. Okay, till Veggie Spread, then F5, then go to Spatial, Visible Cells Only. control C, okay, then control V. So here I got all the product name. Here I got all the product name. So I get all the product name. From this product name, I want to remove this total. This total is coming from all the product which I don't want. Okay, so you are getting this total from all this product. So I want to remove this total. So how can I remove that total from here, guys? So if I want to remove the total, so how we can remove that total from here? If I want to remove this total, so probably I can use this X2 column. I can go to data. If I go to data, so the many ways are there. I can go to data. Suppose I want to remove total from that. I'll go to delimited, and then I can just remove space. Okay, so if I remove space from here, probably I can do next. So many ways are there to remove that. At destination, keep it like that. Finish it. So you get like this. Yeah, see, I try to remove the total, because the problem here I was finding, if I try to remove total, you can see total is somewhere here. It's coming like this. Some part of, if it's three letter name, total is coming here. If it's four letter name, the total is coming like this. So this way, do you think will I able to remove the total? No, right? So what can be the other way? What can be the other way I can use to remove the total? Anyone? How can I remove the total? Suppose I want to remove total. All the total values I want to remove from there. So how can I remove the total from there? Anyone? And even if I want to remove the total, how can I remove the total? Subtotal. If I want to remove subtotal from all these values, so what is the one way I can use? So the one way what I can do, I can use write command and type. And here I'll write the text. I'll write the text, comma. Then I'll use length, L-E-N, length of this cell. Okay, minus, then length of this cell minus find open bracket, find double quotes, comma, again this cell, okay, comma, then find of open bracket, double quote, space, double quote, comma, A2, okay. A2, close bracket, and then plus one, then close two brackets. No, this is not working here. If I use trim function, one minute, right. right of this comma, right of this comma, find double quote, space double quote, comma, then this this length of this minus height, length of this minus height, double quote, space double quote, comma. Okay, so find this number of character. Okay, this comma, starting character, find double quote, space double quote, comma, A2, okay, plus 1. So suppose, clear everyone, anyone any doubt? So what actually I have done, so from I have used the formula, guys. I just selected everything. Then I went to data. Under data, I did text to column. Under text to column, I did delimited. Then delimited, I put tab and space. Then I put next. Okay. Then I put next. Okay. I put next. Okay, and then I when I pressed enter, so everything got separated. The problem in this was this total was coming either in third column, it was coming in fourth column or fifth column, like that. So then I put filter at the top, and individually I went inside the filter and I removed the total part from it. Clear everything, everyone? That was the one way, guys. The other way I could have done it by simply using control H. So I could have removed, no need of doing all this pain. This was the one way of doing it. This was the one way. Then you cut it, and then you can cut it, and then you can do control V here, and then you delete all this. This is the one way. This was the one way. Remove this filter, Alt F. Just remove the filter. I got the product nicely. The other way, what you could have done, the other way, just F5, spatial, visible cells only. Okay, Control C, then Alt ESW, Control V. The other way, if I want to remove total, Control H, find and replace. Find what? Total. Replace with what? Space. Replace all. Done. Clear, everyone? so it gonna happen to us. It is very common. It gonna happen to us. So yesterday, one of my student, he or she is working in Goldman Sachs. So that student has sent like month. That was a column called month, and the value was coming like 01 here, like 01. It was coming like 02. Although for me it's coming 0102, like that the value was there like this. So value was like this 01, okay, value was like this 02, then 03, you're getting 04, and the person want only 1 2 3 4. The person wanted only 1 2 3 4. That person wanted only 1 2 3 4, means the person don't wanted the zero. The zero which was there, the person don't wanted it. So these things happen, guys. When you work in corporate, or when you work on Excel, there is no defined way of doing one thing. You can do one thing by 15 ways. So when at that instant, what comes in your mind, that depends upon how much you have practiced. It's the same like you're playing cricket. So somebody thrown some ball to you. So you can offer infinite shot on that ball. So what is the best shot depending upon where the fielders are there? All that, it all depends upon that particular scenario. So you cannot fix every scenario. I hope you understand. So I got this product name like this. So this was the dummy data. So on where I wanted to use the product name. So I used a subtotal, and with the subtotal, I got the detail of the product. And suppose maybe for data validation purpose, I need that subtotal. So that way I could have, so I can use that support for listing purpose in data validation, all DB. I'll just do remove all. Clear everyone? Anyone, any doubt, any question till now? Whatever I have done, any question, anyone? So you know how to put a border. If you have this data, you can put a border, control A, Alt H B A, Alt H B T. With that, you can put a border. You can see, you can put a border on this data. Okay. I hope you people understand it. Now, guys, the best way, whenever you have a data like this, any data, the best way, what you can do, you can analyze the data by using pivot table. So you can see table. There's one thing called table. Then you have another thing called pivot table. And then you have something called pivot chart. So pivot table, pivot chart. Whenever you click on pivot table, pivot chart, you have an option to get it from in the form of pivot chart or pivot chart and pivot table. So here, what is pivot table and all, we need to understand. Very simple, guys. A lot of buzz is there about pivot table. It is actually very easy. I remember right from the time I'm working on Excel, back in my days of PCS, that time pivot table was looking wise, it was very different to what it is there right now. Anyway, so if you want to put the data in the pivot table, the best way, what I'll suggest you, that always make sure your data is in a table format, so that any changes you do in the table, data automatically in the table format, the data get updated, and the same thing get updated in the pivot table also. So to put the data in pivot in table form, you can do control T, create table. You can put a table on that. You can simply click on table here. Before you put your data in pivot table, make sure your data is in the form of table. So that way the updation part becomes easy. The shortcut key for creating table is either control T or control L. Either you press control T or you'll press control L. In both the case, you can create a table and you press OK. And the moment you put the data in the font table, you can change the formatting if you want. Whichever color is your favorite color, you can put that color. So you can do formatting of the data how you want it to look like. You can do that formatting. Then at the top, you can see this option is coming. Summarize with pivot table. You can do that, okay. Convert to range means, again, you want the table, the data which is there in the table, you want the back to the data in the text form. So you can do that convert to range. So see, just now, if I click on convert to range, what is showing you? Convert this table into the normal range of cells. All the data is preserved. You can click on remove duplicates. If duplicates are there, get removed. Then, so you can click on insert slicer. Slicer means like this product one. Okay, and then you put slicer, like you just select this. Okay, and you can create slicer. You press OK. Can you see the slicer? So you have separate data, like column wise, the data you separated it. Can you see this? So all this, this all the column, now they're coming separately. I hope you understand. So if you want a detail of any product, suppose Alice Mutton, that you remember, no, advanced filter. Yesterday I shown you advanced filter and all. I hope you remember. So I was looking for Alice Mutton data. So you just click on Alice Mutton. So you get the data of Alice Mutton. So remember yesterday I did all this by using advanced filter. Here you don't have to do. You simply click that, you'll get the answer. Chef Anton Cazon season, that data came. Aniseed syrup, that data came. So I hope you're understanding. Jack knew, so that data came. So whatever you click, you'll get the data for that. I hope you're understanding. So this customer wise, click on this customer, data came. You can do that. So you can do that pivot table, you can do slicer, you can play with that. Fine. So the way you can play with that, understand about it more. So these all are self-explanatory. You can use them to learn, spend some time learning slicers by yourself. They're very simple thing. The slicer setting also, if you want, you can do slicer setting. So you can do that ascending order, descending order, how that slicer, the presentation slicer you want, all that, you can do that. So it will come in the same way how you want it to become. Clear, everyone? Let me just delete it. All DFF. Control. Already there in the form of table. So once this is there in the form table, go insert, go to pivot table. So when you click on pivot table, so if your data is there in the form of table, then you don't have to select the table or range. it by default it will be selected. The next thing what you need to do, the Excel will ask you that where you want this table to come, that do you want it to come in new worksheet or in the existing worksheet. So if you say existing worksheet, so then you have to give a location for that. Okay. Otherwise, if you say new worksheet, you don't have to give location. If you say existing worksheet, just press OK. You can get the pivot table. If you say no, I want a new worksheet. So you can do shortcut key for pivot table is Alt N V. Then you say I want a new worksheet. By default, it will come in new worksheet. Press OK. So it came in new worksheet. So it's all up to you. You want a new worksheet or you want an existing worksheet, that you can do. So now guys, what you see, this is called pivot table. This is pivot table field. Now you can play with the data the way you want. If whatever I tick, suppose if I tick on product, so all the data of product, all the data of product came. You can see this. All the name of product came. I hope you remember that time I was doing this only. I was trying to put this product name for data validation purpose. I wanted the name of all the product. So you could have done it very easily by using pivot table. So I can simply copy this. I can simply copy this till here. Control C, Control N, Alt W, Control V. So I'll get all the product name. Okay, so here I got all the way you want it. So the moment you click inside this range, the pivot table will come. Otherwise, outside, no table, nothing. So what you want on this product, I want to see the Q1 value, Q1 performance. You click on Q1, Q1 data came. I don't want Q1. I want Q3. Q3 data came. I don't want Q3 vertically. I want Q3 to come horizontally. You can do anything, guys. Like this product, if you see, by default this product is coming in row, and so you can see that. So if you want this product, you can just drag it, put in column. So you can see now this value is coming for gentle. You can see this. Now this value coming horizontal. Again, drag it product from column to row. By default, it comes in row wise. Here values you're seeing sum of Q3. I want average of Q3. Just click there, go to value field setting and click on average and press OK. Now you'll get the data in the average form. Anyone, any doubt? So you can just click there, value field setting, click on sum, press OK. You got the sum value. I don't want Q3 sum, guys. I want Q1 sum. You got Q1. I don't want Q1 sum. I want Q2 sum. Product wise, I got Q2 sum. Then under each product, I want customer detail. So then click on customer. So you can see under each product what all customers are there, what all sales they have done, all this came. I hope you people are understanding. These all are self-explanatory. The way that slicer was self-explanatory, this is again self-explanatory. So if you don't want to get into detail of this, just suppose you are not specifically looking for all the product customer detail. Okay, you are looking for some specific product customer detail, put that product under filter, put that product under custom filter. Now you can see product is there at the top. You can see all the customer details. You can see all the customer details. You can see all the customer detail. Then go to product. Here, you whichever product, select the multiple items. You remove this. Whichever product, I want only Alice mushroom, any seed syrup, Boston crab meat. Only this product, customer detail. So you can see. So only these product, customer detail I want. I hope you people are understanding. So remove customer. Put product back into row wise. Yeah, it came row wise. So because you remember only these two, three products are selected there. So just to select all. Select all, press OK. You want customer wise all the detail. So click on customer. So customer wise all the detail came. Whatever quarter one, quarter two, whichever you select, that detail will come. You want to select everything will come. You, it's up to you how you want to arrange them. Customer wise values you got. Now you want them row wise. You get the value row wise. Clear, everyone? Anyone, any doubt? Anyone, any doubt? Are you guys understanding? Easy guys, pivot table guys, trust me guys, wherever you go for interview, you know, after your MBA, I just getting news of many people are getting placed from your batch. They are trying individually and they are getting placed. I don't want to quote name of those people. So if you also go outside and try, Bangalore is the place of opportunity. One thing I always tell myself that if you do not get success in Bangalore, you cannot get success anywhere else in the world. That is my confidence in Bangalore, about Bangalore, my motivation about Bangalore. So you can, wherever you go, guys, trust me, guys, if you attend my Excel class, I'm telling you, if you go through all my videos, whatever I've done so far for you people, and go and attend any interviews, so definitely we'll try, not trying, gonna try for sales profile. Even for sales profile, we should be good with it. So even then, after that also, wherever you go and apply, make sure you go through these videos. It will definitely be helpful for you. And do little bit practice. I know many of you people are not having laptop right now at this instance. So I can request you people that definitely you'll have friends or someone who have laptop. So you can take help from them. You can sit with them, do little bit practice, do that much homework before attending any interview, guys. So that is my sincere request to everyone. And please thankful to Reddy sir that for the kind of effort what he is putting for you people. I feel very blessed that to be the part of Padma Shri family. I believe the same thing you should also have the feeling. Okay, everyone. So I hope this pivot table, I hope everyone understood this pivot table. So it's all the way you want the data, the way you remember. I told you subtotal. I told you subtotal product wise. I wanted the sum. You remember we did subtotal. I hope you remember. Okay, so this we did by using subtotal. You don't have to do anything. Subtotal and all, whatever I taught you, subtotal, advanced filter, sum if, count if, average if, whatever I told you, everything fail in front of pivot table. Means fail in the front of pivot table means you just need to put the data in pivot table. The way you want, you get the data. That's it. So here you don't have to use subtotal. Alternatives of everything is pivot table. That's why in interviews and all, they will definitely will ask you. Wherever you go for interview, they will definitely will ask you that, are you aware about pivot table? They will not ask you, are you aware of subtotal or advanced filter, count if, sum ifs, average ifs. So they will not ask you. Many of them who take your interview will themselves will not be aware of it. But pivot table, everyone knows. Anyone who works in corporate, definitely he or she knows pivot table. Because it's very easy to work. I hope you are understanding. I hope you can agree with me. You what you want. You want sum, you want average, you want maxima. Normally what we'll do either sum or count or something like that. So this will work with pivot table. Clear everyone? Anyone, any doubt? So you remember yesterday we were working on Alt F4. So we were working on this company-wise detail. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. We are working on this company data and all. I hope you remember yesterday. I'll just select this F5, then spatial, visible cells only. Press OK, Control C, Control N, Control W, Control V. So, okay, here I don't want this date of birth. Control 0, hide that. Okay, so just select this F5, Control 5, Control G, visible cells only. Or better, I would have removed it. Control C, Control N, Alt ESW, Control V. So I got this, guys. Now it's very easy, guys. So I can use subtotal. For subtotal, Control T, a table format, summarize with pivot table. So new worksheet, existing worksheet, by default it's come in new worksheet. So here name of employee. So you want team leader wise, detail, team leader wise, Q1 sum. Remember yesterday I did. Then, so I did. We use subtotal, we use count ifs, sum ifs and all. You don't have to do anything. So Q1, Q2, Q3, whatever way. You want each, we got some kind of question where I ask you, tell me Amitabh, quarter three, something like this, I ask you. You just need to click on Amitabh, just select Amitabh, you get the detail. And here error chances will be less because you are not doing calculation. Excel is doing and giving it to you. So the chances of error will also get decreased. So the team leader, then department wise, so under Amitabh, all the departments details, it become very easy, guys. For everyone, this all details become very easy. I hope you will agree with me. See this. I saw all the team leaders details also. I want to see all the team leaders or the employees under the team leader, their performance. Under each team leader, the employees. So you can see under Amitabh, these are the employees and this is their performance. So these are the employees, these are the performance. You can see that. It becomes so much comfortable for us to analyze the data, to work on the data. That's why pivot table is in such a big demand. Clear everyone? So in Excel, for doing one thing, you have multiple ways of doing. What way you want to do, that is all depends on you. I hope you'll agree with me. spend time, I'm telling you guys, spend time learning Excel. I request everyone, those who are in first year also, guys, those who are in first year, don't think that next year you will go for a job. So do next year time, that time only you will practice Excel. What is the point of doing it right now? My suggestion for you guys, that I guess you people are in Bangalore, or if you're not in Bangalore, once the thing gets stabilized, come to Bangalore, okay, and start searching job. If online classes are happening and all, start searching job and manage job and classes together somehow. Earn some money, get some confidence in your life, see the world. Don't simply struggle for livelihood. Earn some money, see the world, okay, study simultaneously, improve your skills, improve your Excel communication skills, okay, and make yourself more placeable in the market. That would be my suggestion for you people. Till the time you will not work, you will not get the actual, the purpose of development in life. So that is my suggestion. I hope those who are working, then they can agree with me. So don't simply work because you want to earn money. Work for your self-development. That will give you a lot of confidence. So this pivot table is like this. So you could easily understand the application of pivot table. So the data varies. So on those variable data, you can work. And that way it will make sure that your problem will be removed. Anyone, any question? So now what I wanted, guys, I want to show you simple application of VLOOKUP. So what basically the VLOOKUP do? So by using VLOOKUP, if I talk about VLOOKUP, basically by using VLOOKUP, we pull data. So we pull data by using VLOOKUP, we can pull the data. Okay, so whenever we talk about VLOOKUP and we are trying to pull the data, so you can understand here your data is limited. Here your data is very limited. Okay, but it can be the scenario where data would be too much. You can have infinites of data with you and you're looking for some specific value. So by using filter, you can go and search that specific value. You can do that thing, guys. You can do that thing by using filter. You can search some specific values. Okay, so but that would be time consuming, because imagine if you have to do numbers calculation like that way, and every time if you put filter and go and search individual values, then it will not serve the objective. Okay, guys. So what I'll do, I'll put some product name here, and here I'll put the sum of quarter name here. So whichever quarter name I'll select, I want the sales value of that. Like for example, if I put Boston crab meat, okay, and quarter, if I put sum of quarter one or quarter three, so four something. So I want the sales value of that. So Boston crab meat sum of quarter four. So the value I want it to be 1656. I hope you understand. So this is what VLOOKUP do, guys. What VLOOKUP do, if you press equal to VLOOKUP, VLOOKUP pulls the data vertically. VLOOKUP pulls the data vertically. HLOOKUP pulls the data horizontally. Okay, there's as such no difference between VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. Nowadays, the most powerful command has came, that is called XLOOKUP. That is not working in my system, because for XLOOKUP, you need to have Office 365. So I have Excel 19. So XLookup is not working in my system. So XLookup, I'll teach you some other day. So right now I'm focusing on VLookup. So VLookup, if I open VLookup, so the lookup value. So when we say lookup value, what value I'm looking for? I'm looking for this value called Boston crab meat. So I'm looking for this value called Boston crab meat, comma, table array. So what is my table array? So table array, I hope you understand. Lookup value is just Boston crab meat. Table array means what table, from what table you're looking for the value. So this is the table. You can select this table, control A. So control A is not working. So you can do that. You can simply click here in the first cell, control shift right arrow, down arrow. You can select this data. Okay. Then next thing it is asking you, VLookup value. What value you're looking for? Table array. Third thing it is asking you, column index number. Column index number basically means the column, like you understood, you're looking for a value called Boston crab meat. That is your row value. That is your row. Okay. Then in that, like which column you want, which column. So if you start counting, this is your column one. This is your column one. If you understand, this is your column one, column two, this is column three, this is column four, this is column five. So which column you are looking for a value? Quarter four is which column? Column five. I hope you understand. So the quarter four is column five. Okay. Last one. That you will put, either if you don't put also, you close bracket, you will get the answer. Or you put 0 or 1. 0 means true match and 1 means false match. 2 means like approximate match or like it happens, no? So like in some places, my name is AMIT. Some places, my name is AMITH. So you true match means that it will not accept. So approximate match means it will accept. I hope you're understanding. So if I press enter, so I'll get this value. This is what VLookup basically do. VLookup basically pulls the data vertically. Okay, that is what VLookup do. So whenever we apply VLookup, we pulls the data vertically. Are you getting it? So whenever you use VLookup, the Excel, first thing Excel will ask you lookup value. So what value are you looking for? So you can click that value, what value you are looking for. Table array means, for the table array, select the complete table from where the data to be pulled. Okay. Then Excel will ask you column index number. So what value you're looking for, that value in which column is, that value is there in which column. That also you have to tell to the Excel. That also you have to tell to the Excel. Once you tell that also to the Excel, then probably, and then you just do comma zero and close bracket, enter. Excel will give you the value. I hope you understood this. Now next, if I want phyllo mix, if I want phyllo mix, you see this. If I want phyllo mix, Excel has given me the answer. Here I say sum of quarter three. You can see that phyllo mix, sum of quarter three, phyllo mix, sum of quarter three, 187.6. So manual, no, so I have to change this value. So that is a problem, guys. So here quarter three means it should be fourth column, comma zero. So this, then I have to change the value individually. That is a problem. I have to make it automate. Then only the things can be done. Can you understanding? Are you guys understanding what I'm trying to teach you? Anyone finding anything difficult to understand? Okay, so here, guys, whenever you use pivot table, guys, one thing you need to very sure. Whenever you use pivot table, guys, one thing you need to very sure, guys, that your in pivot table. I'm telling you, VLOOKUP. Whenever you use VLOOKUP, guys, one thing very sure that that whenever you are applying VLOOKUP, whenever you apply VLOOKUP, Excel will ask you lookup value. Excel will ask you lookup value, comma, table, array, all that is there. So the this lookup value, you know, whatever is a lookup value, that lookup value belong to some column, right? This lookup value is belonging to some column, right? Okay, that column should be the first column when you're selecting the data of table array, guys. Please understand this. If you not do that, you'll get error. So whenever you apply VLOOKUP, whenever you are applying VLOOKUP, guys. So here, see this here. Just let me just control space bar, control shift plus. Just give you an example to understand. Suppose this is serial number 1, 2. Just select and drag it. So what I did, I just put some serial number. Okay, I have just put some serial number. Now I want to apply VLOOKUP. So equal to VLOOKUP. Lookup value philo mix, comma, table array. This is your table array. Okay, comma. Then which column? Column numbers. Which column? Quarter 3. Quarter 3 is which column? This first. Quarter 3 is which column? 1, 2, 3, 4. Quarter 3 is fourth column. So write 4, 0. Please understand. So whenever you have to write column number, so you will start from your first column counting. Whichever is your first column in the table array. When you did. Whichever column you took it first, that would be your first column. Are you getting it, guys? Then I'll press enter. Now here you see that although I did everything correct, but even then I'll get error. Why I got this error, guys? Because I told you that whatever is your product name, guys, whatever is your product name, I hope you can see your product name. So whatever is your product name, and then when you select the table array, guys, here, so VLOOKUP in bracket, lookup value philo mix, comma, table array. In the table array, when you're selecting the table, in that table, this should be your first column, guys. Your this product detail, that should be your first column. If before that, if you have selected any column, means you are gone, means you will get the error. I hope you understand. That is the problem with VLOOKUP. So whenever you apply VLOOKUP, this should be, because this philo mix is in this product, right? Philo mix is in this column, right? So when you are selecting the table array, so this should be your first column. You cannot select before it. So this should be your column, first column. I hope you people are understanding. So here, when I use this VLOOKUP, then lookup value is this comma table array. This should be my first column. Control shift, right arrow, down arrow. Right hand side you go anywhere, doesn't matter. But the first column should be the column from where you want to pull the data. Quarter three is which column? So quarter three, start counting from here. First, second, third. So that is your third column. So that is your third column, comma, zero. Close bracket, enter. Clear, everyone? Anyone, any doubt? Anyone, any doubt, any question? Everyone, please reply. Are you guys understanding? Everyone, please reply. Any doubt, anyone? Anyone finding anything difficulty in understanding? Rajendra, I know you only replying. You and Bhagwan only reply. Now Akshay is replying, Divya is replying. Gautam Sharma is replying. Gautam. Okay. Very good, Sonima. UG students are understanding. I'm very happy. All the UG students who are listening, I can suggest them. Once they are done with graduation, make sure you work for a couple of years before doing PG post-graduation. So see the world. Don't think you are very young to work. Fine, everyone. So I hope you people are getting this. So I want this Philo Mix, the moment, whatever product name I put, that get visible here. So for that, I can simply select this product. I simply select this Alt HL N conditional formatting new rule. Go to use the formula, then equal to, click on the first cell, whichever is your first cell, click on that cell, whichever is your first cell, 1 minute, just select the data from here. No need to select this. Okay. Select the data from here. So Alt HLN. Then use a formula to determine which one to select. Equal to. Click on your first cell. So this remove that dollar sign for the from the row number. If this is equal to this cell. Okay, then format, then fill, put color, press OK. Okay, so whatever product name I'll put, suppose Camber Bird, MM Bird, P-I-E-R-R-O-T, Pirot. So you can see that got visible. Then for me, searching the value would be very easy. I hope you're understanding. So, but you see that, sir, you say, sir, one minute. So whatever you are telling, sir, we are understanding, you'll say. But sir, what is this, sir? Camber Bird Parrot Water 3 Sum, sir. It should be what? So why it should be Water 3 Sum? This is what? 9579.5. Okay, sir, that's fine. But what about, sir, if I say I want water one sum? But here, no, it's not changed. So it has not changed, sir. Then are you doing wrong, sir? So I'd say, no, I'm not doing wrong. I'll say manually you need to go, guys, here. And see column one, water one is which column? So I'll say that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you have to do right here, 4, 0. Close bracket, enter. You'll get the value. You'll get the value 3182.4. Then you will say, sir, tell me one thing, sir. For what reason we are learning Excel? We are learning Excel with the reason to automate the work. If we have to do manual work, then better. Already we put the, conditional formatting. Here, what my client want this product, quarter one sum. Manually only I'll go and search. Okay, and then I'll write it down. If half of the work, if I have to do manually, then all the work I'll do manually. What is the point? Half work manual, half work automation. So for that, what we can do, guys, what I can do to help you. So to get the column number, guys, so what way, how we can do to make sure we get the column number every time. We don't have to manually do that work. So for that we can use a function called match. So equal to match, lookup value, what value you're looking for? Sum of quarter one, comma, where you're looking for, lookup array. So you select this lookup array, select this array. Okay, like this, no? From here only we are counting, no? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this will give you that value, 1, 2, 3, 4. You don't have to do that. I hope you're understanding. So equal to match, lookup value. So what value you're looking for? Sum of quarter one, comma. Lookup array means you are counting, no? From the product name you are counting. So like that, Excel will do that counting. So you select the data. Okay, which is your column one? This is row level is your column one. Quarter two is your column two. Quarter three is column three, like that. Comma zero. And close bracket, enter. So what happened? So why this is giving you me error? So equal to match. So lookup. Okay, so why I'm getting error, guys? If you see, this is I wrote sum of quarter one. If you see, there's nothing called quarter one, Q-A-Q-U-A-R-T-E-R. It's not like it is Q-T-R. So here what I need to write, let me try again, the column number equal to match. Okay, lookup value, this is your lookup value. Okay, comma, then lookup array, start from this. Select this, comma zero, close bracket, enter. Now you can see, now it's working properly. Now here, what I'll do, when I'll put VLOOKUP, open bracket, this is my product name, lookup value. Where I'm looking for table array, select this table, control shift right arrow, down arrow, comma, column number. What is my column number? You can simply select this for column number, comma zero, close bracket, enter. And then if you see this, guys, if I press enter, so now here I don't have to change the value manually, like quarter two. See this, it happened manually. Automatically it happened. Can you understand this? Quarter four, this value, I hope you understand. So, Philomix, you see that the moment I put Philomix, it become green. And quarter four value, so you can see I got. I hope you understand. Anyone, any doubt? Anyone finding anything doubt, anything difficulty? And are you people liking this VLOOKUP pivot table, what we have done so far? Anyone, any doubt? Is it clear, everyone? So guys, if I want to put it here together, so I'll write equal to VLOOKUP value. This is the value I'm looking for, comma table array. So in table array, I can select everything. In table array, I can select everything, comma column number equal to match open bracket lookup value. This value I'm looking for, comma table array. So the table array will be this. This will be my table array, comma zero, close bracket, comma zero, close bracket, enter. If I do it together, if I do match together, if I want to use match command together, then anyone, any doubt? Now, here every time I do manual entry, product name and all, I'm writing manually. Okay, some product like Jack's New England, then Clam, Order. So if I write this much big name, instead of writing this much big name, guys, what I can do here, I can use condition, I can use data validation, all DL, okay, and go to list and source, and source, I'll go where this my data, all my product name is there. I can select my product name and I can press. The reference cannot use already, change the reference to single cell, okay. Just do that. Alt DL, okay. List, source, select this name, press open. 1 minute, let me just remove the formula here. Control C, let me put it here, Control V, okay, Alt, Control C, then Alt plus V. Why this is not accepting? 1 minute, Alt V N. Data validation, all DL, list, not working here. Now, here if I apply all DL, list, source, that's okay. So yeah, it worked. So now, so you don't have to, here you can choose any product. Now I choose this product, Chef Anton Cazon Seasoning. It's showing me error. Why it's showing me error? So we look up this. So it's showing me an error. Why this is showing me an error? When I click on this, so equal to lookup value. This is the lookup value for me. 1 minute. Lookup value, comma, table array. So this is my table. Then comma, column index number, use match command. So quarter 4, comma, so select this, comma 0, close bracket, enter. Again, still that error is there. So I can change this product. If I change this product to some other name, still that error part is coming. You can see that error part is coming. So if we investigate this error, so why this error is coming? Is this error coming because of column number? I don't think so. So if this error is coming because of match command, no, not because of match command, then why this product, this error is coming? So you can see this. So Alice Mutton, anything, if I see the product, if I put the product like Alice Mutton, it doesn't matter whatever product name I'm putting, I'm getting an error for this. So why that error is coming, we need to investigate that. What is the need, what is the reason for that? If I put this approximate match, will it work? No, still not working. So we need to investigate here what went wrong. So here we selected this Alice method. This is your range where we are selecting this data. If you want, you can select this value, Control C, Alt ESC. Now, like if you see this equal to V, this is Alice Mutton, comma. So you can see equal to VLOOKUP, lookup value is Alice Mutton, comma, table array, select the table, comma, then column index number, like for example, dummy purpose, I'm just putting 2, close bracket, enter, still that error is coming. So it means if I write this manually, Alice Mutton. If I just select this again, product name. So product name, here if I write here manually, Alice Mutton. and here I write water value. So here I'll write sum of 2 TR, whatever, 1, 2, 3, 4. And if I want to see the value, you want to remove this conditional. Here data validation is there, you want to remove it. Go to home, find and select, click on data validation. Okay, that got selected. Do all DL and then clear all. Okay, now you see there's no data validation. Delete it. Value. If I see, do that, VLOOKUP equal to VLOOKUP. Then lookup value, this is the value what you're looking for. Table array. So table array, select this table array, comma. Then if you quarter two is what? Second column, comma zero. You got the value, right? Now here, if I use here, VLOOKUP equal to VLOOKUP. Then lookup value, whatever is this value, comma, table array, you select this, comma, column number equal to match, and then you can select this, comma, okay, then table array, select this, comma zero, close bracket, enter. You got this value, right? So if I put here quarter four, anything, you see that your values, you're getting the value. Now, what the problem is coming, that when I'm putting data validation, it is creating a problem. Okay, so let's see that how we can work on that. If I do all DL, if I put data validation here, list, because I hope you're understanding the problem we're facing because of data validation. If I select this, okay. So if you see this, now you see this. This is working properly. Can you see that? For this also, I can put a data validation. Right? For this also, I can put data validation. Just see this. All DL. Okay. Here I can put list. Then source, this is your source. Press OK. So you can change the product name. You automated everything, guys. You change the product. You change the quarter name. Whatever you change, your answer is changing. Can you understand this, guys? Anyone, any difficulty? Anyone, any difficulty? Others also please reply. Are you understanding or not? Anyone? Any problem are you facing? I can give a number, row number, column number. Which is this row number, this product, which row number is this? Lookup value, then lookup array. Lookup array, which row number is this? So I can select this. Lookup value, then lookup array. So which row number is this product? This is my lookup value and which product, which is the lookup array for this. So you can select comma zero. This will give the row number. So whichever product I choose, it can give me the row number of that product. Can you understand this row number? And similarly, I can get column number. So which column number is this? So for that, again, match command. Okay, lookup value. Lookup value is this, comma, lookup array. If I start from beginning, comma zero, I can find the row number, column number. I hope you're understanding. Then the answer what you get from the VLOOKUP, same answer you can get from another function called index. The answer what you get from the VLOOKUP, the same answer you can get from index function, equal to index, open bracket, array. What is your array? Select everything. Array, select everything. Row number. What is your row number? This is your row number, comma. What is your column number? This is your column number. Close bracket, enter. You'll get the same value. VLOOKUP and index are more or less the same function, where people prefer index more than VLOOKUP. So VLOOKUP and index more or less are same function only. But probably the tutorials on MS Excel, you'll find many author, many communicator who place index function much more above the VLOOKUP. They believe that index is much more powerful than VLOOKUP. So whenever you do index function, what you need to do, you need to give an array. You need to give an array, comma, row number and column number. It will give you the answer. For getting row number and column number, you can use match command. Anyone, any difficulty? So row number, I can use match command, equal to match, open bracket, lookup value, this value I'm looking for, comma, lookup array, select everything. Close bracket, zero, comma, column number, lookup value. This is my lookup value, comma, array, from where you're looking for this value. Select this, comma, zero, close bracket, again, close bracket, in. So I have taught you VLOOKUP plus match function together, index plus match function together, to get the answer. Then everyone, anyone want to ask any question? Guys, please ask me question if you have any. Shruti, Sweta, Sailaja, Sneha, Sunakshi, Sonika, Sushma, Sushmita, Tasaduk, Tejeshwar, Triveni, Uday, Vandana, विजयदशमी, एनीवन, एनी डाउट, प्रियंका, सहना, सत्यम, रक्षिता, रघुवेंद्र, हरीश, जयश्री, एनीवन, एनी डाउट, कैथरीना, जुलीना, चैत्रा, बासित, राकेश, अखिल अहमद, अंबिका, भगवान, भवन, भूमिका, बिंदुन, बिंदु, चैत्रीना, कैथरीना, जुलीना, एनी डाउट, एनीवन, so index and so the index and match we look up and match, so you can use them together. By using match function you'll get a number, so that number only what we are looking for. In we look up and index function we need a number, column number, row number, so that number we get very easily if we use the match function. So okay guys, we'll take a break. Okay everyone, we'll take a break. I'll see you then at 12 o'clock. Thank you everyone. I'll see you all at 12 o'clock.